I look forward to this opportunity for Fifth Sunday. I think I'd ask Sister Irene to let everyone know that we don't have that many opportunities this year. Seems like last year we had one like every other month or so. But we don't have that opportunity this year. And so I thank and praise God for being here. And we thank you for your giving. We trust that it was liberal giving. We have, as Brother Williams said, Pastor Williams said that, we have good ground to plant our Fifth Sunday seed in. And I thank God. I'm sure there are many that have a special memory, or many special memories associated with our First Lady. And so we were putting the program together, and I said, you know, I think I'd like to testify. Does anybody else have a burning testimony? I'm sorry. I'm not special. But I thank God that, so Sister Hill, I tried to back out of that two or three times. I was like, Lord, I don't want to have a meltdown. And I understand that when we come before and we're in the presence of God in the sanctuary and his people, we have a responsibility for what we say. And so I thought more about it, and everybody's got a story. You know, the last 15 months have been a journey. And so I thought, oh, everybody's got a story. So everybody's had a journey. God, what do you want me to say? And even my daughters were like, Mom, you want us to come, hold you up? We've been holding each other up. Sister Cheryl said, oh, I miss you. I didn't see you last week or whatever. And over the last 3 months, family, friends, I've even turned a couple away. No, don't come all the way up here. I'm fine. I have, you know, my daughters, they act like I don't have nobody, but have my daughters. Yes. They kind of ballsy and they think they run stuff in their house, in my house too. But I thank God for that. And I have a church family.
Yes.
Your guys have gotten so many compliments. You do not know the hearts that you touched during homegoing service. You know, the ushers were on point. They were sharp and on point. You know, those that worked to feed the family, the whole service, it would just went like, they were like, that was him. That was, so I thank God for that. I praise God for that. So I've been muchly loved. I've been fed. I've been spoiled and treated. I've never had a manicure. I've been fed. I'm like, y'all, it's gonna be a slow creep. Y'all quit. You know, I'm good. But I thank God that I know him in the power of his might. Because I don't know how people go along that they don't know him. We had some meltdowns, and like I said, me and my daughters have held each other up. They melt, I melt, and we all melt, you know. But God is so good.
Yes.
And the things I thought, well, I don't want to talk about that, Lord. Again, everybody's got something. But I've been in the corporate environment, and you evaluate things. So you have a project, something goes on, and then you go back and look at it again. What could we have done differently, or what happened, what made it go this way, what made it not go so good? So I began to think about how sudden life is. You know, the word says it's but a vapor. And it's so important that we put everything that we can, that we listen soon enough. I think we were talking about that in Sunday school. People don't say it straight. They kind of make it pretty, they try to smooth it over, but the wages of sin are death.
Yes.
I don't care if it's the president, I don't care who's doing what they're doing and feel like they're functioning in their role, the wages of sin is death. So you need to hear, and you need to hear clearly and understand. And all thy ways get a, and all thy getting get an understanding. So if you don't know, don't get mad, don't leave. This is it. It's gonna be at the same somewhere else. And you'll be bouncing because they're gonna say something you don't want to hear either. But I've learned, you know, life's a baby. You know we didn't come to stay. You know, the word says some will be caught up, but we didn't come to stay. And it's literally, you know, so life is sudden. And what I've learned is, and I say repeatedly, so I look the scripture up, and it's 1 Thessalonians 5:18, and everything give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you, concerning me. Concerning me, I have to give thanks, and I am not going to melt. I'm learning to give thanks in all things. You know, he's ordered my steps, and I won't take but a minute here. So life's like a kind of roller coaster, and anybody's rode those as a child or watched them on TV, and he goes up and it down, and then it swerves that way, and then you don't know, and he goes back the other way. So there's a lot of things about life, and so I'm entering a new season. And what's become apparent? Oh, I'm good, bro. That fan ain't gonna keep me from the mail that I'm talking about. Hallelujah. And so I'm entering a new season. I know there's others in the room that have been through that, and I've watched them go through it. When I first came here, Sister Sharon was so sad. I didn't know her, but I knew something was wrong. And I thank God for having those examples. And so I wrote a couple of things that I've realized that he really does order our steps. He orders the steps of a good man. And he'll give you grace.
Yes, he will. Yes,
he will. Begin to think. We studied several times. You've been here, you know, Pastor believes he's an educator. You keep going over it and over it and over it. Pretty soon you get it. It's just like, oh, yeah. So we don't really know what we think we know, but we studied grace, and I tried to think of all of them, Pastor, and it gives you saving grace. I can't quite remember the rest of them, but I thought about standing grace. It gives you grace to stand. And I appreciate God for that. You know, and then he'll give you wisdom. Stuff you don't know what to do and where to look. And he'll give you all those things in spite of yourself. So he'll give you grace. And the third thing that I've realized is that he really does hold me in his right hand.
Thank you, Father.
So as I said, I've been taken care of. I have a person that calls me. She sits and listens to me cry.
It's all right.
And she prays and I'm okay. So I thank God for my home.
Yes.
I'm trying to get it figured out. I'm trying to be that example, but again, he holds me in his right hand. I haven't wanted for anything. All of a sudden, somebody shows up, and I'm like, can you do that? Do this? I'm learning how to give up things. And one of those that likes to be in control and know what everything is that's going on. We even had somebody just let me sleep. They just came and they folded clothes, they let me sleep. You know, go lay down. You know, so I thank God that I've written several things. You know, woke up this morning and He gave me those three things that as I evaluate my new season, that I thought I could share. I wanted my testimony to be uplifting. And I want you to know that in all this suddenness of life, because the news won't make you happy. Oh my God, it's another tweet. And I thank God, you need to know the Lord just for that. But I thank God, you know, that in all this suddenness, that He'll order your steps. He'll give you grace for whatever it is. And He's always got you in His right hand. You know, He loves us. He loves us so much. He gave His only begotten Son. And I'm not going to preach because we have a wonderful, I'm not going to hold the time anymore. We have a wonderful speaker this morning.
Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Well, I had a song prepared for this morning, but after hearing her testimony, there's been a song that has been in my heart for the last couple of weeks, and then Sister Shante mentioned it this morning. So I think that song is very befitting right now. And it says, "You are my strength. Strength like no other." And it says, "In the fullness of your grace, in the power of your name, not my name, not your name, but in the power of God's name, He lifts me up." God has been so gracious to my family. A couple of weeks, maybe about 3 weeks ago, I happened to look into my phone and I saw some things that I wasn't pleased with. And sometimes God just tells you not to say nothing. And it's because He's already got it. He's already got a plan for it. We don't always know it, but if we trust Him, He gives us a glimpse of what He's doing. This past Monday, my oldest child was filled with the Spirit, the Holy Spirit, with the evidence of speaking in tongues. This child has had a battle since the third grade. Since the third grade, people have been coming up to her, and this girl was ministering, she didn't even know it. But I have a special plan for you. The devil has fought her. Someone had laid hands on her, and then she ended up being. It taught me at that time that I gotta be careful who I allow to lay hands on my children. But Monday, hallelujah, whatever stronghold was on that child's life was broken. It was broken. It was broken. Hallelujah. Glory to your name, Jesus. So God has been so gracious. He has been so faithful. Glory to your name, Jesus. Glory, Jesus. You are